Good day, people. This is Zephirmous talking, and in this video I'm gonna point out my top 5 worst achievements that someone can accumulate throughout his or her Genshin Impact experience. I will also give you some tips on how to get them and make a rough estimate on how much time is required for someone to accomplish each achievement. Now, before I begin, I would like to mention that this video will not include any commission related achievement. There are some achievements that a lot of people still do not have in their possession because that one commission just doesn't come up in their daily quest feed. Okay, with all things considered, let's begin. Number 5. Well, that was strange. This achievement is part of the Challenger Series 2 category and it requires you to find and kill the unusual Hilochar 50 times. Our unusual friend can spawn in 16 total locations at any time of the day. Once you find one and defeat it, another will spawn in one of the other 15 locations. When that second one is killed, there will be a 12-hour cooldown for the next Hilochar to spawn, and the cycle goes on. Now, let's say you are hell-bent to accomplish this achievement as fast as possible. How long will it take? Well, considering that you find and kill the unusual Hilochar twice every 12 hours only in your game's world, then it will take approximately 2 weeks. You can also try to join other player worlds and ask for help. However, there is still a limit to 10 kills per day in all worlds, so good luck. Number 4. Hitherto unknown. This achievement is part of the Hero's Journey category and it requires you to reach maximum friendship level with 16 characters. Every character's friendship level, aside from the Traveler, starts from 1 and goes up to 10. There are a few ways to obtain friendship experience in order for a character to be ascended. The easiest way is by hosting characters as companions in the Serenity Pot. Other ways require you to have the character or characters you want to ascend in your team party, and those are by doing daily commissions, consuming resin, and by completing some random world events. Some of them can also be done in co-op mode, and you get double the amount of XP with the cost of having fewer party members. Now let's make an estimation on how much time is required for a character to reach friendship level 10. Every character requires nearly 30,000 companionship XP to reach maximum level. You can roughly get 640 XP per day, but that happens if you meet certain conditions. Some of them are by being adventurer level 55 or higher, you have reached maximum adeptal energy in your Serenity Pot, and you use that character to complete all of your daily commissions and consume your 180 daily resin. It will take you more or less 45 days for you to max just 4 characters. The achievement requires you to reach friendship level 10 with 16 characters, so I believe you get the grasp now. Number 3. Bounty of the Earth. This achievement is also part of the Hero's Journey category and it requires you to collect 800 ley line rewards. It might seem easy and straightforward at first, but this achievement requires a lot of time, effort and energy resources. Everyone has spent quite a few resin to obtain rewards from a ley line, whether it be money or character experience materials. You can either spend 20 resin or 1 condensed resin to obtain rewards from a ley line once. Original resin are limited to 180 per day for every player individually, so all in all it will take around 90 days or 16,200 original resin by consuming every last drop of your daily resin in exchange for leyline rewards. This achievement is one step forward to unlock one of my favorite name cards in the game, but still, it is not wise for someone to devote himself into accomplishing this achievement, because original resin is currently the most important currency in the game, after Primogem, of course. Number 2. Stop, gather time. This achievement is part of the Serenity Pot Realm Beyond Series 3 category and it requires you to gather 800 sea plants from a Path of Value Orderly Meadow landform field. Now you might be asking, why did I choose this specific landform field instead of the Jade field or the Luxuriant Glip? You see, in gardening, Orderly Meadow is the only landform that has no seeds that yield more than just one plant per seed. Once you plant a seed, then you only get one plant in return, unlike other landform fields, where you're able to get up to 4 plants from just one seed. Now let's do the math. You can only have two copies of the same field at the same time in your Serenity pot, and every field has a capacity of 4 seeds. Lastly, seeds can be planted in fields inside the Serenity pot and harvested after nearly 3 days. This is equivalent to 8 plants per 3 days. So how long will it take for someone to accomplish this achievement? It will take practically 300 days. And yes, you heard that right. I think this is the most time-consuming achievement in Genshin Impact, though it doesn't require too much effort. Everyone can get this achievement just by being patient enough and plant seeds from time to time. Number 1. Ding, ding, ding. This achievement is part of the Teyvat Fishing Guide Series 1 category, and it requires you to catch 2000 fish successfully. Now, I don't even need to indicate the ridiculous amount of effort that a player needs to put in here. Currently, there are 34 total fishing spot locations on the map, and every world has around 200 total fishes at best, both day and night. The whole process will take several unbearable hours of you casting your rod, changing day to night, night to day, and traveling from one location to another. Assuming you got everything, you have to wait 3 days for them to respawn or try to join other player worlds and ask for permission to fish there. It is also worth noting that the bonus fish caught by using Thomas' passive talent Snap and Swing do not count towards this total. Anyway, how long will it take for someone to accomplish this achievement? I believe it will take approximately from 30 to 35 days without trying co-op, and that depends on the total fish spawn rate. It appears that this video has reached its end. I really appreciate that you took the time to watch this video until the end. Zephirmous, signing off.